Hello guys, good afternoon. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Miss Henderson. I hope you're having an amazing day. So today I am coming to you with a few ACLS test questions. These questions are from the American Heart Association ACLS textbook. So I hope you enjoy this short video, and I hope these test questions can enhance your ability to pass the ACLS course. So the first question we have here, so again, if you like these types of videos and these types of educational content, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. Please give this video a thumbs up and please drop your comments below. Please be polite with your comments. If you have a suggestion for me, please be professional in leaving comments on my channel. I really don't have the time to deal with any type of behavior that is unethical or unprofessional. If you need to bring something to my attention, you can leave positive comments or constructive feedback, things that I can do to improve my channel, or things like educational content that you would like me to create for you. So that being said, let's dive into this video. First question is, what is the recommended first intravenous dose of amiodarone for a patient with refractory ventricular fibrillation? Take a moment and think about the answer, and I'm going to tell you the answer. Is it 1 milligram? Is it 1 milligram per kilogram? Is it 1 milliequivalents per kilogram or 300 milligrams? So that moment is up, and the correct answer is 300 milligrams. That's the correct answer, and I have bolded in kind of green colors so you can see it. It could pop out. Question number two, which condition is an indication to stop or withhold resuscitative effort? A, unwitnessed arrest. B, safety threat to a provider's. Patient age greater than 85. No return of spontaneous circulation after 10 minutes of CPR. So which condition is an indication to stop? If, of course, you have to always establish that the scene is safe. If the scene is not safe, then you're putting yourself at risk for harm. So you can stop if there's safety, if the scene is not safe. So B is the correct answer for question two. Question three. What is the recommended next step after a defibrillation attempt? Is it A, open the patient airway? B, determine carotid pulse? C, check the ECG for evidence of rhythm? D, begin CPR starting with compressions? So take a moment and think about the answer. So the correct answer for this question is to check the ECG for evidence of rhythm. Guys, if you have any questions or any concerns, please log on to the American Heart Association 2020 guidelines for evidence-based practice research on the latest evidence-based practice on CPR training. So please log on to them. They provide evidence-based practice, and their information is the most current and most accurate. Question number five, what is the recommended second dose of adenosine for a patient in refractory but stable narrow complex tachycardia? A, 3 milligrams. B, 6 milligrams. C, 9 milligrams. D, 12 milligrams. So take a moment and think about the answer. So the correct answer is 12 milligrams. That's the correct answer for question five. Let's look at question That was question five. This is, should be question six then. Okay. What is the recommended oral dose of aspirin for a patient suspected of having acute coronary syndrome? A, 2 to 4 milligrams, B, 80 to 120 milligrams, C, 160 to 325 milligrams, D, 400 to 600 milligrams. Take a moment and think about it. That moment is up, and the correct answer is C, 160 to 325 milligrams. So we did five, we did six, so this should be question number seven. How long should it take to perform a pulse check during the BLS survey? A, 1 to 5 milligrams, 1 to 5 seconds, B, 5 to 10 seconds, C, 10 to 15 seconds. D. So the correct answer, take a moment and think about it. Correct answer is B, 5 to 10 seconds to check the carotid pulse. If there is no pulse, then you have to start CPR. Question eight. Question eight, what is the recommended compression rate for performing CPR? Think about it, guys. Think about the answer. A, 60 to 80. 80 to 100. Is it D, as in David, at least 100 per minute? That's the correct answer for question eight. D, as in David, at least 100 per minute. Question number nine. What is the most reliable method of confirming placement of an endotracheal tube? A, 5-point auscultation, B, colorimetric capnography, continuous waveform capnography, D, use of esophageal detective device. So take a moment and think about it. The correct answer is continuous waveform capnography. C is the correct answer for question number nine. Question number 10. We have the same slide here, so I'm going to actually edit this slide, delete this slide, because we have the same thing twice. 9, this is 10. Which treatment or medication is appropriate for the treatment of a patient in asystole? Take a moment, guy. Atropine, epinephrine, defibrillation, D, transcutaneous spacing. Take a moment and think about it. So the correct answer is B, epinephrine for a patient in asystole. That's question 10. This should be question 11. What is the minimum systolic blood pressure one should attempt to achieve with fluids, inotropic or vasopressors administration in a hypertensive post-cardiac arrest patient who achieve ROST? Take a moment and think about it, guys. Is it 90 millimeters of mercury, 85 millimeters of mercury, 80 millimeters of mercury, 75 millimeters of mercury? Think about it. You're hypertensive, means your blood pressure is dropping. You don't have enough fluid. Maybe you're in a cardiogenic shock or fluid volume deficit. So the correct answer is A, 90 millimeters of mercury. That's the correct answer for number 11. Number 12. What is the appropriate ventilation strategy for an adult in respiratory distress with a pulse rate of 80 breaths per minute? One breath every 3 to 4 seconds, one breath every 5 to 6 seconds, two breaths every 5 to 6 seconds, two breaths every 5 to 8 seconds. So what is the correct answer, guys? Think about it. The correct answer is B, one breath every 5 to 6 seconds. And that's question number 12. Oh, we got a last one, I guess. Question number 13. A patient with pulsed ventricular tachycardia is defibrillated. What is the next action? A, check for pulse. B, administer an IV antiarrhythmics. C, start chest compressions at a rate of at least 100 per minute. D, repeat the unsynchronized shock increasing to 200 joules. So take a moment and think about it. What do you think is the correct answer? So the correct answer is C, start chest compression at a rate of at least 100 per minute. That's the correct answer for this question. Guys, I think that's it for this video. Thank you so much for tuning into this short video. And I hope these questions can help you to pass your ACLS course. I provide educational material once or twice a week on different educational topics. And if you like these type of content, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. And please give this video a thumbs up and please drop some constructive feedback below. Thank you for watching. And I'll catch you in my next video. Ciao for now.